then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Oh, now a running play here with Smith. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Being chased out left. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. DK Metcalf, 54 yards, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. After a fairly uneventful first quarter, that last play, that'll make a few highlight clips.
It certainly will, and you're exactly right. The first quarter almost felt like a feeling out process, didn't it? Both teams, okay, what are we going to do? Looks like they ramped things up just a little bit to start the second quarter.
Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And a great return. Solid field position. He's up all the way to the 45-yard line.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. He'll set up the screen to Marcus Allen. The first down screen pass, good for 5. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. On second down, Peyton. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Now Jackson on first down. Flush to his right. And oh, a dangerous throw there. Nearly intercepted on the sideline, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing is Jackson. He'll buy some time right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw is Jackson. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. And the Dolphins are going to get it back here just past the 35. Boy, he had to fit that into a pretty tight window over the middle. And, Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes just fooled by the type of zone that he sees. Because oftentimes those linebackers will vacate and run downfield with receivers. In this case, he played a pure zone and was in the wrong spot for the QB.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. to the air. Allen. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8. They do go for it. Here's Allen. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. Jackson's throw taken in by Moss. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
And we came into this one focused on Randy Moss, and now he has our full attention with his first grab of the game.
Well, he's one of only two players to go a whole season averaging over 100 yards receiving and average a touchdown per game as well. That's a pretty impressive stat.
It really is, especially when you consider that every defense he faced was prepared for it and was kicking coverages in his direction.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. He's going to run it here up the middle. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And only able to get this to the 19. So probably should have opted for the touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
Flushed out right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off by the 13-time Pro Bowler Ray Lewis. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. You don't want to coach him, Charles, to stay in the pocket on every play, but I guess that's the danger of getting outside of the pocket, extending a play, and making a bad throw. Turns into 6 points the other way.
Yeah, sometimes when you get outside the pocket, your vision actually gets obscured a little bit, or you narrow it down too much, and you don't see all the defenders in the area.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And, Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. Second down. They'll run now with Peyton.
And not a whole lot to speak of there as he'll bring him down shy of the 20. 3 yards on the pickup there, but they've only got it back to 3rd and 10.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Jackson toward the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Now it's Jackson eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, 1st and 10. And Jackson throwing once more, escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. 2nd and 10 now, 3rd quarter from Charlotte. Running it here with Peyton. And he's going to be met at about the 43. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Jackson. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let it go deep. Right sideline. Man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. 1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. On the run, it's Peyton. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. We have played 3 quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. 2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. And they'll turn to a power game to try to get in. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the 1-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. Here we go. It's Jackson on 4th down. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. They're turned away on 4th and goal.
Go for it, yeah, dude! Go for it, yeah!
Ready for their next drive. Turnover that just got him the football back, obviously a big one, because had they been able to score on the other side, this would have been a 1-possession game.
So you don't sense full relief here, then?
No, I don't think, especially with the ball this deep in their own territory, because you make a mistake, they've got it right back in prime position.
They certainly do. So now, almost like, you know, almost like a 4-minute offense, right? Take care of this bad boy. Make sure the other team doesn't touch it, but move it with consistent gains. Wear down the clock and make them use their timeouts in this situation.
The Dolphins on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Oh, they go with a tight end carry. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 41 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles.
But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race.
Bring it.
And
bring
all
it.
The way in for a Miami touchdown. Marsh.
Nah, don't quit yet, trash. Don't quit yet, trash.
Back again up in this. Entertaining for you. Come for my M's, you get this double, double. In this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rumble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud, ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you late. Why you out on your run? Taking victory laps. I'm in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta. I hit the blue flame later with them two-tone gates. Who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying. Professional imitators. Rap, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back. You pop, pop. Like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. To get this one started, and we are underway from Heinz Field. This will be fielded inside the five, and the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Throwing on first down. Pickett dancing to his left. And his first pass is incomplete.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Steps away to his left. He'll have a first down past the 40. And finally brought down at the 38. A big connection on that one. 36 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. They'll look to throw again. Flushed out right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Well, there's Sam Hubbard that time in there to bring him to the ground.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And I think the ball's out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
He's thankful right now for that sideline because it could have been a fumble loss, instead just a fumble, though they will have to punt it now.
You're right about that, but do you think there's ever been a player happier to see his own punter go on the field than him?
No.
I mean, not at all, right? How fortunate is he that he got a chance to punt it away? And it's not just a turnover at the spot.
Helps big play on the drive, but that was enough to put them in field goal range.
Yeah, one big play of what they hope will be many others throughout the game. Every team has a different target for the number of plays like that, those explosives that we talk about. That allowed them to put points on the board on that drive. Let's see how the rest of the game goes.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Here's Smith to return it. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And shedding the tackle, and now some room. And on his first carry, he loses the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And they have the football and will set up. Shop at the 33-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so. No, bottle, not fumble. It's out, it's loose. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And this is brought all the way back. A fumble recovery and taken to the house for a Miami touchdown. Second time he's lost a fumble. This one hurts more. It's returned for six.
He's been under a lot of duress, hasn't he? Pressured, hurried, harassed the whole game.
Well, the offensive line not giving him a lot of help.
Not a lot of help, but the bottom line, he's got to take care of the football.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Taking it about the one. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for six.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will repeat it, and that's what you don't want to do.
On first down, Pickett eluding the pressure right. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Options galore here, second and a few inches. A first carry for Najee Harris. And he's got some space here. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Najee Harris, 49 yards. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead. Extra point by Anderson. Up and good. It is now 10-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Here's Smith to return it. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. On the give, this is Harris. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on third and 12. On the ground, it's Harris. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Another down on the scoreboard, but the urge to go for it is almost irresistible here on fourth and short. Yeah, I know. I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
Well, the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well, well short of a first down. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. Now a first down carry for Harris. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Looking to throw. Pickett buying time to his left. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Forced out to his left. That's caught by the tight end, Whitecheck. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Here's Smith to return it. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They'll start on the ground with Lynch. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
On 2nd and 9, Allen. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. They'll throw with Allen. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. So 2 plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's 3rd and 16. Now Allen. And he goes out right around the 39. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Well, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down. They're going to try and throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's picked by the linebacker, T.J. Watt. When I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
Being chased out left. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sack back at about the 43-yard line. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Back to throw. Pickett. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Picked off by Nick Bolton.
And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And he will be brought down on what will be... down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. Oh, trying to gauge the sun, and he muffs it. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
On second and 11 now, Allen. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's a give to Lynch. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. A give to Harris. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Again, they'll pound it with Lynch. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Boy, not deterred from those first two failed attempts. They're going to go a third time here on fourth down. Throwing now is Allen. Dancing to his left. Allen hit. He lost the football. And it looks like Steeler football. It is. So they tried it. Not only did they not get the first, they fumbled it away.
Yeah, it's one of those things where it went from bad to worse, but I know that everyone's going to pile in on the call and say, well, what are you doing? Why would you go for it there? I think that teams that are convinced that they feel pretty good about their game plan, what they want to get done that day, go for it. Give it a try. Hey, let's see if your defense can rescue them a little bit.
59 yards rushing for him now to this point. 4 yards remain for second down. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On first and 10, Pickett steps away to his left. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Buying time to his left. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Off play action. Pickett rolling to his left. And all this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. So the scoring dried up here in the third. Nothing that quarter for either side. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Off the play fake. Pickett. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. They hand this off to Harris. And he gets it down to the 32. 9 yards on the carry, but it's going to lead to a fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to perhaps salt this one away. The Hall of Famer's kick is good. And now it's a two-score game at 9, 16-7. To Allen, CD going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
There's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down two scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly.
On first down, Allen escaping the pressure right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time. And I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Throwing again on second down. Allen flush to his right. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Allen now looks to throw. And they try to set up the screen, but that almost disaster as it falls incomplete. Very nearly a turnover, but it's fourth down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now Allen, gotta have this one. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. And